Hi, I'm Nick Nanton, and welcome back. I'm here with my good friend Tony Hansman, behind the scenes of Real Heroes, The Rudy Story. Tony, what's up, man?
I'm doing good. How about you?
Good, man. Hey, so why don't you tell our viewers a little bit about what we're doing here?
Well, I got involved with this because it's kind of a story that goes in a big circle for me. When I was, I got pictures when I was a little boy in a crib. My dad had Notre Dame pictures of Joe Montana and, you know, banners in the crib and stuff, and pictures of my granddad and my dad screaming at the TV during Notre Dame football games on Saturday. And so, but my parents could never really afford to get us up to a football game. And so years later, I'm a freshman in college, and my roommate says, hey, look, my dad's got season tickets to Notre Dame. I'm like, yeah, I gotta go. So our first night there that we get there, we get in, it's a really snowy night, but the next day we wake up and there's camera crews all over the campus. They're filming Rudy.
Wow.
And so here we are, you know, 25 years later, and it's been full circle for me.
Wow, that's crazy. So yeah, we're here making the documentary, Real Heroes, The Rudy Story. Tell us a little about last night. We had a private dinner with Rudy and the group. What was that experience like?
I think it was awesome. You know, it was just a chance to, you know, small setting to get to sit, you know, just a few feet from him and ask questions and hear kind of behind the scenes of what he liked, what he didn't like. Just kind of how they put the whole story together. I thought it was amazing.
I thought so too. And then we got the Rudy private tour of Notre Dame this morning. How'd that strike
you? Super cool because, you know, he would walk up to people and see if they recognized him or ask him what their favorite sports movie was of all time, and to see the reaction of those people's face, people falling on the ground, you know, realizing who he really was. That was just amazing.
That was a pretty cool reaction. Now, you're helping us make the movie, helping us to produce it, so thank you for doing that.
Absolutely.
Let's talk about the first time, obviously you saw him filming it, then the first time you saw the movie. What struck you about watching the movie the first time?
I think, you know, I've got kids now myself, and so to see a movie when I was practically their age, and now to see them experience, you know, the movement, you know, the passion, the to never give up type of a story in, you know, that generation behind me. And it's just a story that just keeps giving. It never wears out. I think that was a huge portion for me to be a part of. I really like that story. It's much bigger than I think what people think it is.
Absolutely. And so now being able to tell a little bit of maybe the behind the scenes and introducing the world to the real Rudy, what made you want to get involved in helping share that story as a part of it?
You know, I would say, hope. I think he mentioned it too. You know, he talked about there's hope, and I took from him to have gratitude, to celebrate the little victories in life, and all those things. You know, I think we can all relate to those things, no matter what industry that we're in. And so I think being a part of something like that is really huge, something that is going to go on for generations.
I agree, man. Just sharing the story even further, just being, I mean, for me, just honored to be a part of it, and thank you for helping us tell the story.
Absolutely. Thank you.
All right.